Hello friends, it's time for the third video dedicated to getting acquainted with Matter over Thread devices. If you haven't seen the first two, you will find links in the description. I remind you that Thread is a physical protocol, an energy-efficient mesh network, similar to Zigbee, but with several differences, such as the use of IPv6 addressing for its nodes, support for multiple main nodes in one network called border routers, and so on. Matter is a logical protocol for data exchange between the control system and the device, through which parameters and commands are transmitted. The main physical interfaces for it are Wi-Fi and Thread. The hero of this review will be one of the most common smart home devices, the Aqara P2 door and window sensor. This is one of the latest models that uses Matter over Thread for communication with the smart home. Additionally, I will talk about one of the problems that can arise when connecting the device to the network and a solution to it. Before we begin, as usual, please like this video, as it will help others interested in smart home topics find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. This is the global version of the device. So the box looks different from the more familiar Chinese versions sent from AliExpress. By the way, I haven't seen this model there yet. Under the brand name, the type of sensor is indicated in English and French. The model codes for global versions also differ from those used for China. For the P2 opening sensor, DW-S02D. In addition to Thread, it also supports BLE, but not for constant use. Only for initial connection to transfer account parameters. The power source is a CR123A battery. The delivery set includes the sensor, magnet, instructions, and an additional mounting kit. For global versions, the manufacturer provides multilingual instructions. In this case, it is available in 10 different languages. Since there is no physical space on the sensor itself for placing the QR code for connection, it is found only in the instructions. I checked whether this code is unique, as there was a hypothesis that it might be the same for a group of devices. I found a photo of the code of another Aqara P2 sensor, and as seen from the digital version, they do not match. Therefore, besides needing to keep the code, if you have several identical sensors, you should somehow link it to the specific unit. The additional mounting kit consists of spare pieces of double-sided tape. Along with them, the box also contains two small magnets, presumably for use in places where it is difficult to place a large magnet. Structurally, the sensor is completely identical to the P1 version, which works on Zigbee. The shape and size are the same. The main unit is 77 by 22 by 22 millimeters, and the magnet is 36 by 11.5 by 7.3 millimeters. There is a round button on the front. On the back, double-sided tape is already attached, with the one in the kit being a spare. The device is most often installed on windows or doors. The sensor is quite large, much bigger than the first Zigbee versions. This is largely due to the use of a capacious, and consequently large, battery. On one of the narrow sides, there is a slot where you need to carefully insert something flat, and by prying off the cover, remove it. Inside, we will find a 3-volt CR123A battery. The stated capacity is 1,400 mAh, which should last for several years of continuous operation. In the transport state, a spacer is installed to prevent the battery from discharging. This needs to be removed. The connection process is similar to the socket I showed in the last video. In the mobile app, go to the Devices and Services menu, click on the Add Device button, select Matter Device from the list, and then New Device. When you insert the battery, the smartphone might automatically detect and offer to connect the sensor, but it is more correct to do this through the Home Assistant app. Therefore, if you see something similar, choose the Not Now option. Next, follow the algorithm. Open the camera, scan the QR code from the instructions, and wait for the device to be detected. Then, the connection process begins, initially via Bluetooth, generating the Matter account, then connecting to the Thread network and Home Assistant. From the system's perspective, this is a typical contact sensor. There are two entities, a binary sensor displaying the current status and a battery level sensor. It reacts in real time, and everything works correctly. During testing, I moved the sensor behind two concrete walls, but the connection was not lost, and the system continued to respond to events. Here are both connected matter over thread devices, the contact sensor and the socket from the last video. I mentioned that I am showing an ideal picture, but the technology is still under active development. As promised, I will talk about one of the problems I encountered. It can occur if you created a thread border router, synchronized the network credentials with the mobile app, but then for some reason, your network changed. This can happen, for example, if you reset the border router or replaced it physically. The point is that the current network is no longer the same as at the time of the first synchronization with the mobile app. No matter how many times you resynchronize or reinstall the Home Assistant app, you won't be able to connect the device to the network because the credentials remain the same as during the initial synchronization. I have left a link to this issue on the Home Assistant GitHub in the description under the video. As of the video's release, it is still open. Actually, the problem is not even on the Home Assistant side. Remember, I mentioned that the device connection dialog pertains to Google Home. The Thread network credentials are part of the Google service, and the workaround is to delete all app data. This leads to the removal of various settings and data, including, for example, bank cards in the wallet app. That's why I did this on a tablet, not a phone. At least I didn't have to re-add all the cards. After that, resynchronize the credentials with the app and then proceed with the connection. In my case, Home Assistant said Matter was unavailable, so I had to launch Google Home and manually start adding the Matter device, interrupting it at the very first step of scanning the QR code. After that, the connection process went smoothly and quickly, and I reconnected both the socket and the contact sensor to the new network on the first try. But I can't call this method a solution. It's a workaround with several complications, and I didn't even have to relink bank cards to the wallet. In conclusion, I will also show the web interface of the OpenThread border router add-on, which I discussed installing in the first video of this series. At the bottom of the configuration page, there is a switch called Show Disable Ports. Activate it, and in the newly appeared fields, enter the port numbers. I chose the default ones as they were available for me. Save the changes. Then, go to the web interface at your server's address, followed by the port number with a colon. In my case, the address is 192.168.0.45, and the port is 8080. The interface is still quite raw. The only useful feature I found is the network map. The largest purple circle represents the border router. I have only one, and it has the status of leader. If there are multiple routers, there will still be only one leader. But if it disconnects, this status will transfer to another router. Smaller circles represent a simple router, the socket, and the end device, the contact sensor. At the moment, I believe it is not advisable to rush into switching to a thread network. The potential is definitely there, and using Matter will eventually lead to the disappearance of device compatibility issues, making everything work seamlessly together. For example, the devices shown in these videos connected well to the Tuya Smart Ecosystem Gateway with Matter over Thread support. However, due to Matter version 1.2, it did not yet support energy monitoring sensors, only the switch. It would be great if connecting devices to a Thread network were as simple and straightforward as Zigbee, but for now, unexpected problems can arise at various stages, like the one I mentioned today. That's all for now. I would appreciate your likes on this video, as it helps its promotion on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the next episodes. In the description, I will leave all the necessary links to the devices and other reviews I mentioned, my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for smart home discussions. Join in, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention, see you soon, and peace to everyone.